Hello all, welcome back to the module 5 in digital system design. So in the previous sessions, we saw the sequence detector, and we'll go to the one more application, that is design of code converters. Okay. So I think code converters you might be already aware of. So converting one form of code into another, like gray to binary, binary to gray. Similarly, in this particular example, we'll take up the BCD to XS3 code converter and how to come up with the circuit. Okay, so the problem statement is we will try to design a sequential circuit to convert a BCD to XS3 code. So we typically target the Mealy machine. This circuit adds 3 to a binary coded decimal digit in the range 0 to 9. That's what. Okay, so if I have a binary coded decimal 0, the 3 will be added to that, so that XS3 becomes the 3. If the binary coded decimal is 1, means if I add 3, it becomes 4, so it goes on. The input and output will be serial with the least significant bit first. Okay, so what is the meaning of that? Means when I try to code any number using BCD, it requires 4 bits. That is, one BCD digit requires 4 bits, and that's what here I have taken, the BCD, which is input. So 4 digits, so I am taking something like T0, T1, T2, T3 as 4 variables kind of thing, or a timing. Okay, so because it is a serial input that we are giving, so I mean by T0 is one timing, T1 is another timing, T2 is another timing, and T3 is another timing. I am not only using this timing as a timing variable, but also it will be one of the bit variable for this BCD coded. Okay. So T0, T1, T2, T3, T0 being the least significant bit and T3 is the most significant bits. Okay, so 4 variables. So I can have 10 BCD numbers using 4 bits. Okay, starting from 0000, which is 0. And the last one is 1001, which is 9 for me. Okay, so if I add 3 to this BCD, I get the XS3. That's what 0011 is all about. So similarly, for each BCD number, I try to add 3 and I get the corresponding output. Okay, so this is what the output, you know, again. So if this is the present state input, means the output will be the next state. Okay, so T0, T1, T2 and T3. So here what exactly we'll try to do is, we define output for each state here. So for T0, depending upon the X input, okay, at T0, what is my X? That depends upon, that decides the, after the time T0, what will be my Z. Okay, so this is what is all about. Okay. So below table list the desired inputs and outputs at times T0, T1, T2 and T3. After receiving the 4 inputs, the circuit should reset to initial state, ready to receive another group of 4 inputs. Okay, so once I get the 4 bits serially, from starting from T0 to T3, so something like this, from right to left. First I get this, then this, then this, then this. After I receive 4 bit, that is one BCD number, the system should reset to initial state. That is what the problem statement is all about. So now from this particular truth table, okay, we'll try to design, or we'll try to obtain the state diagram first, or the graph, what you call. Okay, so before going to the state graph, we'll try to analyze how to go ahead with the state diagram now. Okay, so now at time T0, if I see this very first column in the at the input side, that is BCD number T0. Okay, if I see anything like this, either I may get T0 as 0 at time T0, my X input may be 0 or my X input may be 1. Okay, if I get at time T0 X as 0, so my output, that is Z, will be 1. Okay, if I get 0 as X input at time T0, my output will be 1. If not, if I get X input to be 1 at time T0, my output will be 0. So I can define the output, that is Z, at time T0 depending upon my X. If X I receive as 0 at time T0, my output will be 1. Or if I receive X to be 1 at time T0, my output will be zero. So there will be always a change that is happening. Okay, so this is what I'll try to do now. So suppose T naught. Okay, so I'll take something like this. This is my state A, and state A is my kind of initial state, or the reset state, what I call. Okay, this is with respect to time T naught. Okay, this is what I'm trying to make. Okay, I am in initial state, and in the initial state, my timing will be in respect to T naught. Okay, then I will check what is my x. Depending upon x, I will set my output in terms of x as 3, that is my z. Okay, so this is what I'll try to do. Okay, suppose again at time T naught, my x input may be either 0 or it may be 1. If I get x is equal to 0, I have to ensure that is z is equal to 1. If not, if I get x is equal to 1, I have to let output z to be 0 for time t naught. Okay, so this is what I am trying to do now. That is based on this particular table. Okay, so now when if I get x is equal to 0, okay, 0, my output is 1. Okay, so this is a Mealy Moore machine that we are trying to build a design. Okay, so if x is 0, my output should be 1 at time t naught. That's what I'm saying, 1. And I will move to some state which I call it as something like B. Okay, if not, if I get x as something like 1, what should be my output? That is 0. So I'm just seeing two columns, one at the input and one at the output. In the input T naught, and in the output also same T naught. At T naught, x is 0 means my output should be 1. If not, x is equal to 1 means my output should be 0. In both the cases, I'll try to move to different next states. So next state of A is C when I get x is equal to 1 and I let output to be 0. The next state of A will be B if I get x is equal to 1 and I let output to be 1. Is that okay? So this is really happening at time T naught. Yes. So when I am in either state B or C, that is the time when I am in T1. So then first I analyze. So you can see that in the entire column of T naught of input and output, when input is 0, output is 1. When input is 1, output is 0. Okay, so it is just complementing. So our problem with respect to the first column is done now. Okay, so what we'll try to do? If my least significant bit of the input BCD is 0 means my output least significant bit, I make it 1. If not, the least significant bit of the input BCD is 1 means I let the output to be 0. And here we are assuming that input comes in serial. So first it will be T naught, then the next bit will be T1, then I will get the bit in terms of T2, and then I'll get the most significant bit at timing T3. This is what I'll try to do. Okay, so we are done with the first now, first column, that is the least significant column. Now I'll go with something like T1. Okay, so I should ensure that if I'm in T1, I've already encountered my T naught. So if I am in B, okay, if I am in B, that means the bit received is 0. If I am in C means the bit received is something like 1. Okay. So now at B, if I am in T1, again here, I may get 0 or 1. You can see that either I may get T1 to be 0 or to be 1, 1. And since it is the second most least significant, if the least significant bit is alternating 0, 1, 0, 1, the next bit has to be alternating with respect to 0, 0, 1, 1. Okay. So we'll try to see that for 0, 0, for 0 and 1, I have four different combinations. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. Okay. So now, for if I am in timing T1 along with T0, if 0 and 0 means I've already defined what is my more least significant output. Now I have to define with respect to T1 now. Okay. If I get 0, 0, that is T0 zero and also at T1 zero, my output will be 1. If it is 0 1 something, my output will be 0. If it is 1 0, my output will be 0. If it is 1 1, my output will be 1. That means at T1, I'll be setting the output 1 and 1 if the T0 and T1 both are same, that is 0 0 or 1 1. If not, they are different, 1 0 or 0 1, I'll be letting the output to be 0. So now at B, again I have two conditions. I may get 0 or 1. Okay, so if I get 0, it will be 0 0, this 0. Then what I'll try to do, C, I'll be, then I'll go with something, I call this as something like D now. Okay, this, if I get 0, I'll go to this. So when I'm in B means it is 0. After that, once again, I am getting the input X to be 0 means I am bit received till B is 0. After B, I am receiving again 0. That means 0, 0 means my output will be 1. And I'll go to this. Okay. Is that okay? This is what I'm having. If not, I'm in B, already bit received is 0. If I get 1, so at B means I have received 0 already. Then instead of 0, if I get X to be 1 means I let the output to be 0 and I move from D to E, something like that. Okay, this is what happens now. Yes. So I have done with 0, 0 and I am done with 1, 0. So one with respect to T1 and another with respect to T0. Okay. So now T0 and T1 with respect to AB is over. T0 with respect to A is over. Now T1 at C, I have to see. That means the bit received is 1. That means I am targeting this row and this row. Yes. If I get 0, then I will move to this now. If I get 0, I'll move to this with output 0. Or I may go to some others, F, I call. If I get something like 1, by letting the output to be 1. Either similar to B having two states, you can also have two states for C also. Okay, so I'll just tell that. Okay, yeah. So something like this. Okay. So you can call this as something like G when you get 0 or output is 0. So when are you in, if whenever you are in D, you have received 0, 0. Whenever you are in E, you have received 0 and 1. Whenever you are in G, you have received 1, 0. And whenever you are in F, you have received 1, 1. Yes, you can see that. If it is 1 1, output is 1. You can see 1 1 means output is 1. If it is 1 0 means it is 0. Again, it is 0 1 means it is 0. If it is 0, it is 1. So you can see that for 0 0, T1, T0, it is output is 1. For 0 1, it is 0. For 1 0, it is 0. For 1 1, it is 1. So similarly, we try to go on constructing the table. Again, at F, we are in terms of T3. Okay. So at T3, we have already received. If I'm in D, 0, 0, then it is 0, 1, then it is 1, 0, then it is 1, 1. Again, if I'm in 0, 0, that means this is done means, again, I'll be receiving at T2 with respect to 0, or I'll be receiving with respect to 1. Okay. So this I'll be dealing. Okay. So in similar fashion, we'll try to construct, and that is what we'll try to see the complete state graph for this particular table in the next slide. Okay, so we'll try to summarize. We see that at time T0, if the input is 0, the output is always 1. And if the input is 1, the output is always 0. Therefore, there is no conflict at T0. And this is what we have said. At time T1, the circuit will have available only the inputs received at T1 and T0. Okay, that is two bits, two least significant bits. There will be no conflict at T1 if the output at T1 can be determined only from the input received at T1 and T2. Okay. So similar fashion in which way I have explained, in that way I have specified here. Okay, if 00 has been received at T1, T0, the output should be 1 at T1 in all three cases where 00 occurs in that table. That means this is what they mean by. Okay, 00, 00, 00. You can see that at T1, they're all 1. Okay. If I receive 01 or 10, 01 or 10, 01, I let the output to be something like 0. Then when both are 1, my output will be 1. This is what they're trying to say in that particular table. Okay. So something. For sequence 10 and 1, the output set at T1 will be 0 and 1 respectively. So therefore, there is no conflict at T1. In similar fashion, we'll try to go ahead with finding out T2 and T3 for all inputs when all inputs are available. So there won't be any problem. And this is what the complete state graph here. Okay. So as I said, okay, I'd said that at A, this is my T0. Okay, my X. So numerator is X and the denominator is Z. Z is output, X is input. Okay, at each timing variable T0, T1, T2, and T3, we'll try to see what is my X input and what will be corresponding output. Okay, and X appears in terms of serial. Okay, so state A is at timing T0 when I receive X. If X 0, output I'll let 1 and I go to B. If not X is 1, I let the output to be 0 and going to C. And B is the bit received is 0. C, bit received is 1. Similarly, D is bit received 0, 0. You can see that you can trace. At A, if I get 0, X, I'll come here. At B, once again, if I get X as 0, I'll go to D. If not, F means it is 0, 1 received. For E, it is 1, 0. The X 1 coming to C. And then you are going to E when you get 0. So this is 1, 0. And this is 1, 1. Then P means similarly 1, 1, 1. This is 1, 1, 0. This is 1, 0, 1. This is 1, 0, 1. I is in terms of 1, 0, 1. This is 0, 1, 1. This is 0, 1, 0. This is, I already 0, 0. This is 0, 0, 1. This is 0, 0, 0. Okay. So my BCD number, 4 bit, 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. And 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay. So these are the 10 one digit BCD numbers I have. So total 10. But we're using 4 bits, I can have 16 combination. That is 1, 0, 1, 0 till 1, 1, 1, 1. I'll just encode something like this. So these are 6 numbers. These are 10 numbers. Okay. So 6 are unused here because I can't call 1010 as a BCD number, one digit BCD number. Is that okay? So for 10, it has to be 0000. Oh, sorry. Yeah. 0001 and it has to be 0000, something like that. Okay. So at H, if I get 0, I'll go here. So that means after H, I'll move out. That means at H, if I get my Z0, that means 0000. Okay. So the last most significant bit in this, in when I'm in B, the bit received is 0 and my Z output is something like 1. Okay. At C, my Z output is something like 0. Okay. So the year, what I mean by year is not only I receive the X values, but also I set my Z value. Okay. So you can see that at T0, input is 0, output is 1. At T0, input is 1, my output is 0. So Z here I am defining is 0 with respect to my T0. At B, again, the moment I get input to be 0 at T1, my output to be Z. So I let output to be 1 here. here I let output to be zero. So whatever the output you are seeing in the second row, okay, these are with respect to T1 outputs, and whatever the outputs you are seeing in the first row, it is with respect to the one T0, and whatever you are seeing the Z output with respect to 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, it is with respect to T2 output, and whatever the outputs you are seeing in the fourth row, they are the outputs with respect to T3 in the output column. Okay, so we will now proceed to set up the state table. Okay, so from this state graph, we'll try to obtain the state table. Okay, so the arrangements we'll try to see. And as I said, out of 16 combination using 4 bits, only 10 are valid, and for rest all we use the don't cares or dashes. Okay, so here there are, we have taken A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, P. Okay, so these are the different variables we have taken at different timing. So for each variable, we'll try to give the names. Okay, so that is the binary sequence. Okay, and that's what we'll try to do in the next thing. Now, we'll try to ensure the state graph we're converting into a state table. This is the state table for me. Okay, so what is this basically? This is the state table for me. This is basically the state table, okay, that we derive from the state graph that we had the previous. Okay. So we consider the timing in the first column, T0, T1, T2, T3. So input sequence received. Okay. So as I said, present state A is the reset state or the initial state. Okay. Then depending upon X, either I'll move to B or C. That's what. The next state of A is depending upon X value. If X is 0, I'll go to B. If X is equal to 1, I'll go to C. Correspondingly, if X is equal to 0 at time T0, my output should be 1. If X is equal to 1 at time T1, T0, my output will be 0. Okay. So this is the output Z. At each timing sequence for the corresponding input X, either 0 or 1. Similarly, when I'm moving to B, okay, this is the bit received at B. What I mean by this is the bit received, input sequence received. At A, I receive 0, and at B, 0 is already received. Okay. C means you can see that the next state of A is B and C. Okay, so B is receiving C0 and this is 0. Okay, this is similar to what we did in the previous, right? Okay, you can see here. Okay, B means is already bit received is 0. C means bit received is 1. Okay, my output is with respect to 1, 0, and that's what we have done over here also. Okay. 1, 0. Similarly, we try to construct. At D, it is 0, 0. You can see that. Okay, sorry, I have to go back. Yeah, at D, the bit received is 0, 0. 0, 0, 0. Here, 0, 1. Here, 1, 0. It is 1, 1. So in the similar fashion, we are going there. Okay. 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. What is the next state? We have already given here and corresponding outputs. Yes. And when I'm in this H, if I get X0 equal to 0, I let output to be 0, but I won't be going to any next state because my sequence 4 is already over. I may come back to the initial state, that is the reset condition. Okay, so something like that. So you can see from from J, K, L, M, N, P, from J, K, L, M, P, okay, we'll move to the initial state. Okay, next state will be, next state from all these will be this. So what we'll try to do is, we'll try to ensure that the next state after coming here, all we have given to A. So, okay, this is what the reset is all about. The next state of H, L, J, N, I, M, K, P, all will be where? To the A. And that's what we have specified in this particular thing also. Okay. So whatever may be, I'm in the present state. From H onwards, all states will have the next state to be zero. So when x is equal to zero, all will be zero. And only in when x is equal to one, from hi I'll be a. In next all condition, it is don't care because we are not getting any proper sequence. In the similar fashion, this is also the case. Okay, so this is what really the thing is all about. Okay. So this is, and now what we'll try to do is, now we'll try to. So you can see that in most of this, okay, most of the if I see this next state and this output, okay, you can see that AA, next state of this column is AA, the present output is 01. You can see that these two column are same, and then you can see that these two column are same. That means I can say that J equal to K equal to L equal to M equal to N is equal to P, meaning the next state and the outputs of J, K, L, M, and P are same. Similarly, the next state of H, I, J all are same now. Is that okay? Yes, that's what. Next, we'll reduce the. I will try to reduce this table now. Next, we'll reduce the table using row matching. When matching rows which contain dashes, a dash also we can consider because a dash will match with any state or with any output value. Okay. By matching rows in this manner, we have H is equal to I is equal to J is equal to K is equal to L is equal to L and M N is equal to P. After eliminating, so I can just simply eliminate I, J, K, L, M, N, P. We find also E, F, G and the debut, E is equal to F is equal to J because the outputs are 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Is that okay? Y means I is equal to J. In this case, okay, so what we'll try to see now, okay. For example, this don't care, this don't care, this is don't care, okay. This is don't care, this is don't care, this is don't care. What we say is, this dashes match with any state or with any output value, okay. With any output value, this may be matching with 00 or 01, okay, something like this. So this is don't care. So what we try to do is, since this don't cares are there, it will match to any state and with any output, we try to ensure that all these states are same. H is equal to I and that is equal to J and that is equal to K and all these things. When HI, J, K, L, M, N, O, P are same means, here I can be replaced by I only, J can be replaced by I only, K also can be replaced by I. And if I see E, F, G, they have all the next state same and all the output same. So that's why E, F, G are also same. Okay. So now what we'll try to do is, we'll try to retain A, B, C, D and then E. Because out of three, we'll take it one. So we will have the first five rows and then we will have the H. Okay. So totally we will be having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as the row reduce, and that's what we'll try to see in the next particular slide. Okay, you can see that A, B, C, D, E, H and M. H, why we'll be taking it is AA. The only reason why we'll be taking this H is, okay, AA 01, AA 101 minute. If I'm in H, just a minute. If I'm in H, okay, all zeros, 0, 1, 0, 0, J is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. This is with respect to my, this is 0, 1. This is 0, don't care. This is 0, don't care. If I'm get, this is don't care 0. This is 1, 0, okay. So this is 0, 1, 0, 1, on, yes. Then we'll have something like this. 3 plus 3, 6 and 1, 7. Okay, only M is changing with respect to this. So totally we reduce the state table to this transition. State table and transition table both are one and the same for me because I have to find out what is my characteristic equation. Okay. So this is the final simplified version of state table comparing to this. We are trying to reduce this to a simplified version. And now there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 states, I can use 3-bit to represent 7. A will be with respect to 000, B will be with respect to 100, okay? So C will be 101, D will be 110, something like that, okay? So we try to match accordingly, okay? So this is what we try to have. So again, next state, from A, I go to B when X is 0, or I'll go to C when X is equal to 1, okay? So this is what I'm trying to have now. Similarly, I have encoded B as 100, C as this. And then from this, I'm going to have this in terms of this. So again, I'm trying to design this particular code converter using D flip-flop. There are 3 flip-flops, Q3, Q2, Q1, or 1, 2, 3, whose outputs are Q1, Q2, Q3. Similarly, I should get the next state, okay? So there are total 3 variable for the present state and 1 input. So I have to use 4 variable KMAP in order to get Q1 plus, Q2 plus, Q3 plus, as well as Z, okay? So doing that, I can get D1, that is Q1 plus, as Q2 bar, okay? X, Q2, Q3, X and Q1. Similarly, I've taken 4 variable KMAP in order to find Q2 plus, that is Q1, which is nothing but what, D2, and Q3 plus as this combination of SOP, that is nothing but what, D3, and Z is something like this. These are the expression obtained for the next state of first flip-flop, that is Q1 plus, Q2 plus, Q3 plus. And for the next state equation, characteristic equation of a D flip-flop is Q plus is equal to D. So whatever the next state I get, that will be the input. And that's what we'll try to do. And this is what. And this is the 3 flip-flop that I'm using. Okay. And this is my first flip-flop. This is my second flip-flop. And this is my third flip-flop. This is the corresponding Q1. This is Q2. And this is my Q3. And we had got D as Q2 bar. So that's why I'm directly connecting something like this to this. This is D2. This is D1. And this is my D3, okay? So for D2, it is Q2, Q1. So directly I'm connecting to this. And for D3, it is the sum of products of all this. Sum of this one product, sum of this one product, sum of this one product. I can use three input OR gate I can give, but I have realized using the NAND gates here, okay? So you know how to realize using the NAND gates. And clock is common for all. And the output is nothing but what? It is this X, Q3. And this is X bar, Q3 bar. It is something like a XNOR operation. That is the output that I'm getting. So this is the code converter circuit, okay? Which converts an input BCD to an XS3. And input, we are giving the 4-bit in terms of serial, okay? If my first bit is 0, next bit is 0, next bit is 0, next bit is 0 means, okay, after the first bit comes, my Z will be 1. After the next bit comes, the second, say first, this is the least significant, next, the next subsequent bit, this is my LSB and this is my MSB, yeah. First LSB, my Z is 1. Second bit, it is 1. Third bit, 0. When I get the most significant bit, it is 0. You can see that for 000 combination, this is 1, 1. This is the binary BCD 0. This is the XS3 code. Okay, this is what the code converter circuit is all about. So this is one of the application of the digital circuit in terms of the media and the mode. So in the next session, we'll take up some more example. Till then, bye, thank you.